you see, the efforts of DPEX is that it has demonstrated the capacity and capability to forge synergy and partnership between relevant institutions, which is a strategy and the beginning to break the silos of institutions that we now have. We are now operating in pockets and in silos. We are not partnering. We are not sharing resources. We don't know what each other is doing. For example, I mean, if you take the very weak example of the electoral, the allocation of a lot of resources to put a voters register. I mean, this same voters register is similar to the information required by a population commission because it is the same people. The data is similar to what is required by the immigration people where we get our passports. The data is similar to what is required by the identity card people. Now, it would have been strategic to place the Federal Office of Statistics in the center, merged with Galaxy Backbone that have demonstrated IT capability to house data, to manage data, and so on, and then surround them with these data-requiring institutions so that we now establish a backbone database and information whereby we can say, Nigeria, we have arrived. These kind of synergies, our partnerships under this platform will definitely provide. So based on what we're trying to do, you will now start seeing clusters of institutions emerging. Think institutions that I may call as the national systems of innovation. It enables people to relate to each other, to share information, so that we can be able to push our country on the right track. This is the elements for leapfrogging, which is possible, and that is the contribution of our partnership, I guess.
I have actually proposed that government gives 1% of their budget, nationwide budget, to science and tech, specifically for research and development. Most countries even give more than that, some 2, some 2.5. Nigeria currently does not even provide up to even 1%, not even to 1%. I'm sorry, you know, 0.1%, yes. Not even up to that. If we can give only 1% of our budget to science and technology, specifically geared towards research and development, you will see in some years to come how Nigerians are very innovative.
Yes.
And IT is a knowledge-based, you know, sector development area. You don't need to carry a lot of things to go, just a laptop and then, you know, internet access.
Nasini's business is to develop technologies where you notice a soffit. And we've taken programs in energy, in manufacturing, in agriculture, in education, and we have impacted all of these areas. Okay. We have done national programs that people know that the area of education, done national programs, where we have developed mobile laboratories and got people to pay for this and spread that all over the country. It has been crazy that government still buys, because the other time I was seeing in newspapers that the guy who was running NAPEP was going to pay ₦500,000 for the NAPEP. And he got a few billion. That is not to establish a factory in this country. Based on, because, look, for God's sake, I can appear is a doddle.
Yes.
It isn't a brain surgery or anything like that. And yet he went ahead and bought, so it bothers me. But since I don't control the policy, I will man my stable very well. I will do my work with the ultimate. And I will do advocacy where I can, but I won't kill myself for other people's foolishness.
And the high standards, if you look at the globe today, is that countries that have been able to effectively acquire technology have got globally recognized products. For example, Nokia in Finland, Tata in India, Kia in South Korea, and so on. Nigeria needs to have those type of things. Similarly, countries that have made prominence and put a footprint on the global technological development has demonstrated that they are able to, using indigenous technologies and manpower, evolve companies and brands that are even quoted on stock exchanges of foreign countries, globally recognized companies. For example, Infosys of India, Nestle of Switzerland, and so on. Nigeria needs to do that too.